Today, I'm building an AI agent that writes personalized cold emails for you. First, let me show you a quick demo. Here I have a lead list that contains the name, company, website, and email address. Let's execute the workflow. It pulls the data from Google Sheets, creates a personalized email using AI, sends the email, and updates the status on Google Sheets. Let's check our inbox. And here we go, we've got the email. It also updated the status on the Google Sheet as well. Now I'll walk you through the step-by-step process to build this workflow from scratch. So let's get started. First things first, we need an N8N instance. I always suggest railway.com as the best platform to host N8N. The user interface makes it easy to install and maintain N8N in a few clicks, and the plans are cheaper than other platforms, starting from $5 a month with great resources. If you use the link in my video description, you'll get the $20 plan totally free for the first month. To install N8N, just go to the Railway dashboard, click on New, tap on Template, search N8N, select the first one, and click Deploy. Within a few seconds, your N8N instance will be ready. It's that easy, so you should definitely check it out. Okay, now let's start building our workflow. First, let's add a schedule trigger. Tap on the plus icon, search schedule, and select schedule trigger. Here, I'm planning to execute the workflow and send one email every 5 minutes. Let me choose the trigger interval as minutes and set minutes between triggers to 5. You can customize this trigger depending on your preference. Back to the canvas. Now let's add a Google Sheets node to pull the lead details. I've created a Google Sheet that contains some demo leads. Here we have the name, company, and website. These are the details I'm using to personalize the email. If you have more information, like business pain points or anything else, you can add it as a new column and use that too to make the email copy even more personalized. And here we have the email IDs column. I've added my own email address for this tutorial. The next column is status. Once an email is sent, it will update the status to sent. So on the next execution, it will pick the next row. Back to the canvas, click on the plus icon, search Sheets, and select Google Sheets. Set the action as Get Rows in Sheet. First, we need to connect our Google account. If you don't know how to connect it, we've created a separate video on that, and you can find the link in the description. Here, choose the document. In my case, I named it Leads List, and then select Sheet 1. Now we need to add a filter to get only the rows where the status is empty. Click on Add Filter, select the column as Status, and leave the value empty. Let's execute the step, and here we got 3 items, but we need only 1 item at a time. So click on Add Option, select Return Only First Matching Row, and enable it. Let's execute it once again, and here we go, we got the first item. Back to the canvas. Now let's add the AI agent node to create the personalized email. Change the user message to define below. And here let's add all the details we have. First add name, then drag and drop the name string. Next add company and drag and drop the company string. Now add the website. If you have more details, as I mentioned before, you can add them here. Next, we need a specific output format from this AI agent. Enable this option and at the bottom, click the plus icon. Select Structured Output Parser. Remove the existing part and add Subject colon Subject, Body colon Body. Now our AI agent will output in this specific format with a subject and a body. Back to the AI agent node. Click on Add option and select System Message. Here we can add some instructions to create the personalized email. I have already created a structured system message, so let me paste it here. It is very simple. You are an expert cold email writer with 5 years experience. Your job is to generate short, personalized cold emails that propose AI and automation services to businesses. Keep the tone friendly, human-generated, simple, and clear. Always personalize the email using the details provided in the user prompt. Avoid generic lines. Write the cold email in 4 to 5 lines max. Focus on how AI agents and automation can help them improve efficiency, reduce manual work, increase sales, and streamline operations. Do not add placeholders or brackets. Produce only the final email body with no introduction or explanation. Add signature, best Rajiv. So, this is the system message I use to create personalized emails for my AI and automation services. You can update this based on your services or business. To get a better structure, you can copy this. I'll add it in a blog post, and you can find the link in the video description. Then go to ChatGPT, paste it, and ask it to modify the system message for, let's say, your video editing services. It will give you the updated system message. Okay, back to the canvas, close this. Next, we have to add a chat model. Here we have multiple options available. I'm choosing Google Gemini, which is free, and we've already created a video on that. You can find the link in the video description. Let's execute the step. And here we go. We got the personalized subject and body. You can control the output by adding more system instructions if required. Back to the canvas. Now let's add the node to send the emails. For that, you can use Gmail or the SMTP node if you want to use your domain email. And even Outlook emails work perfectly. I'm keeping it simple by using the Gmail node. Set the action as send a message. Select your Gmail account. In the to field, we need to add the recipient email address. So click on the Google Sheets node and drag and drop the email string like this. Now, in the subject field, drag and drop the subject string from the AI output. Set the email type as text. Then drag and drop the body string into the message field, and it will look like this. Click on Add option and select sender name and add your name here. Click on Add option again and select Append N8N attribution. By default, the emails sent by N8N contain a watermark. We can remove it by disabling this. Perfect. Now let's execute the step. It's done. We got the output as sent. Let's check our email. And here we go. We got the email. Now comes the final step. Once it sends the email, we have to update the status on the Google Sheet. For that, let's add a Google Sheets node. Set the action as update rows in sheet. Select the same document and the same sheet. Set the column to match on as row number. In this field, we have to add the row number string. Just click here, then drag and drop the row number string like this. And here, we have to keep only the status field. Add the value as sent. So after sending the email, it will update the status. Let's execute the step. It's done. Let's open the Google Sheet. And here we go. It updated the status. Now it's time to do the final test. Let's execute the workflow. It takes the data from Google Sheets, creates a personalized email using the AI, sends the email, and updates the status on the Google Sheet. Let's open our email, and here we go, we received the email. It also updated the status on the Google Sheet as well. So, once we activate this workflow, it will trigger and send one email every 5 minutes. You can customize the trigger depending on your preference. For example, I modified this workflow a bit here, and it triggers at November 13th, 10 a.m. and then we added a loop node to process the emails one by one. At the end, there's a wait node with a 2-minute delay, so it will send one email every 2 minutes. I will include both of these workflow JSON files in a blog post, and you can find the link in the video description. That's all for today. If you have any doubts, feel free to let me know in the comments. We will be uploading more AI and automation videos in the upcoming days. So, don't forget to like and subscribe. See you in the next one.